Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome back to Lowell Park. My name is Josh Rothstein. I'm joined by Ben Gainsboro. Tonight, this afternoon's matchup is the Cotuit Kettleers against the Orleans Firebirds. And, you know, after this game, both teams have their Fenway workout tomorrow. So even though that's, you know, an off day on the schedule, it's a busy day. And then after that, the games come in quick succession with all the rainouts. Most of the days off in July and even pushing into doubleheader territory have been used. So coming out of the Fenway workout, Orleans has 17 straight games. Meanwhile, Cotuit on pace for 23. So it's, you know, today and through the rest of the season, both teams' depth and ability to hit up and down the lineup is going to be tested. Cotuit had some momentum coming off the sweep of Brewster in Sunday's doubleheader. It kind of stalled a little bit Tuesday night in Chatham. An interesting game, some controversial calls, and eventually Cotuit couldn't just get the hit they needed, Ben.
Yeah, Josh, interesting is the perfect term for that game. Neither team played poorly in that game, but also neither team really outplayed the other all that much. Jackson Wolf got the start for Cotuit, and if there has been an area of weakness so far for Cotuit this year, it's been that starting pitching, but that was not the case yesterday. Wolf's first start had come about a week prior, and in that start, his first inning was definitely a little rocky. He walked a few guys, let in an early run. Coach actually had to go out and settle him down. This start was much different. He was lights out from the get-go. He had 7 strikeouts, only allowed 2 hits. Unfortunately for him, those 2 hits were both home runs. And for Cotuit, they only had 5 hits in the game and only 1 extra base hit. Both Will and I have talked about it. 3 is the special number for Cotuit so far this year. When they have hit 3 or more extra base hits, they are 5-0-1. When they've hit 2 or less, they are 1-5. So look for that special number 3 today versus Orleans. Back to you.
All right, thanks, Ben. Orleans sits a half game better than Cotuit thus far this season at just 6-4-1. They've really gone with the pitching staff. That's really helped them to those 6 wins. As you mentioned, Cotuit needs the extra base hits to, you know, usually win the game. Orleans is pretty stingy with how they give up their extra base hits in their pair of 1-0 doubleheader wins over Wareham on Sunday, 2 1-0 wins. They give up just 1 extra base hit in both games combined and just 3 walks as well. So that pitching staff has really been dynamic for the Firebirds thus far this season. They have had 7 starters who have pitched more than 4 innings and haven't given up a run, and so that's pretty impressive from their point of view. They usually, the guys get in the game and stay in for quite a while and don't give up a lot of runs. Today's starter is one of those examples. He's probably been their best pitcher this season, Adam Seminaris, a junior out of Long Beach State, today's projected starter. He has a 1-0 record. He's thrown 8 2/3 innings, 4 strikeouts, and no walks over his almost complete game stuff over 2 starts. So he pounds the zone, puts guys, gets his defense working, and they're usually right to him. Those guys usually make the plays. So look, that's something to look out for in today's game. Cotuit's going to try and maybe work his pitch count a little bit, get in a good spot in the count, and hopefully be able to get a good pitch they like. Offensively for Orleans, it's Max Traime who leads their way at the top of their order. He's a senior out of Bentley. He leads the league in average, hitting .378, and he's on a 4-game hitting streak, in which he's 7 out of his last 15. They also do have a little power in their lineup. Raymond Gill and Josh Zamora, both juniors, Miami and Nevada respectively, they have 2 home runs each. So Orleans is led by their pitching staff, but they do have some offensive pop in their lineup. Ben, thanks so much. We'll send it up to Sam and Aram for their thoughts pregame.